Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters, and most distinguished guests. The word "fan" derives from the word "fanatic." But the word "fan" consists of two meanings. The first meaning is a device for creating a current of air or a breeze. The second meaning of fan is an ardent devotee, an enthusiast. Today, I'm going to talk about the second meaning of fan, an ardent devotee, an enthusiast. Throughout my high school, I observed how some of my rich classmates who were fans of popular singers and film stars. Likewise, these popular artists were their idols. Every day they talk excessively about their idols. They talk in the classroom, outside the classroom, and after school. What did they talk about? For their idol singers, they talked on the clothes they wore, the shoes, the necklace, like the earrings, the watch, and the songs they sang. Also, their personal affairs. And as for their idol film stars, they not only talk about their attire and personal affairs, but also about the episodes of the movies played by their idols. Eventually, these classmates of mine started to copy the way their idols dressed. As a result, they often look much more mature than their age. As teenagers, they really spent a great deal of money. Besides, they also bought books, magazines, posters, tapes that were of their idols. They eventually built up one-sided relationship with their idols. And they confessed to one another that they had fell in love with their idols. So they started sending cards, letters, and gifts to their respective idols, but were never replied by their idols personally, and yet they did not mind. Every day, their mind seemed to be occupied only by their idols. And so, they did not do well in their studies. Their parents then had to spend extra money to send them to private tutors or tutoring centers. When their idols were getting married, they would feel depressed. And some even cried. Nowadays, fans do not only do the things that fans of those days did. In fact, they are doing more. For example, some rich fans today would travel from one place to another, or from one country to another country, just to follow their idols when their idols were touring for concerts or promotions. They even lined up for hours under the heat of the scorching sun when there was an autograph session or promotions held by their idols. Some fans today even attempt to commit suicide if their idols were going to get married. As I observe and I realize, fans really pay a great price, time, money, and emotion for the sake of their idols. I also realize that fans of popular artists are more unrealistic in life. While we were so extremely crazy over their idols do not know them most of the time, and even at all time. Contest chair. 好，对。
Oh, hey, I love you. You're the best.
Okay.Young masters and friends, did Mercy do a great creative job through her opening? She not only showed creativity in presenting us the right definition of fan, her definition of fan, her objective of fan, but also through showing her creativity through the usage of props. Who needs PowerPoint when you have creativity like that?But on one side, in the future, if you want to take that creativity a little bit further, maybe you can make your prop a little bit larger so that the audience from the right side and the left side and those sitting all the way in the back can enjoy your creativity as well. Now, Mercy, congratulations. You have shown great creativity, and that is a very important element in making a great speech. But if we're going for challenging your comfort zone, let me bring one little suggestion, and that is the addition of an appropriate amount of exaggeration. Exaggeration in what? Body language, vocal variety. Today we're talking about fans, and fans do not go, oh, Ed, I love you, you are my idol. That would be me trying to tell the boy I like that I like him. No, fans would go crazy. Yeah, I love you. So with the exaggeration, you can make your fans real fans and not a shy little girl like me. I'm very shy, I am. I'm just really good at hiding it. Second thing, with a little extra exaggeration, you can make your conclusion a little bit more powerful.I can tell from your speech that in the end, after comparing fans of yesterday against today, you want to tell us fans waste a lot of time, money, and emotions. But make it more motivational. Tell those people who waste a lot of time, money, and emotion, and tell them to invest it in the Toastmasters. Would you not feel motivated? Yes. So, Mercy,thank you for showing us creativity in the usage of props and an interesting opening. But expand your comfort zone by adding a little bit of exaggeration. And soon you will be the star, followed by thousands of fans, not only from Taiwan, not even from the world, but from the entire universe.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm very honored to be Mary's evaluator. She has shared with us a very interesting story, her observations of the fans who were chasing after the stars and everything. Now, what I'm particularly impressed with her speech are that, first of all, it's very well organized. She started off by painting us a picture, a scenario, and then went into supporting details. Lots of examples were provided. We see her talking aboutfans were dressed like the stars and everything. And also, she used good props. She brought up a light prop. Yes, light. A card, which made the topic really clear. And she went on to use lots of hand gestures. to accompany her speech. It was all good. Now, in terms of suggestions, I have a number of them for you. First of all, as an audience member, when I'm listening to speech, I am looking for a valuable and a significant message. And I think I would suggest you to revise the content a little bit so that it offers a significant message, not merely the observations. What are the suggestions? I mean, what are the messages that you're trying to tell me? And second of all, I want to say that you could have a stronger opening. In your opening, you brought us the life props. How about acting out the what the fans would do? For example, oh, George! You know, that's what the fans do. Oh, George, you know, may I have your signature and all that. That would be a bit dramatic, and it would add a more impact to your speech. And for your conclusion, I think it would be just as good if you could revise a little bit so that it ended with a stronger conclusion and calls for action. And for example, you could say, as for me, I would definitely watch my daughters, make sure she doesn't. And as for you, the audience, I would suggest you to pay attention to your teenagers and stuff like that. You know, calls for actions. And the one last suggestion is that you have a lot of room to your disposal, and you could walk to the left, to the right, and move back, and it will sure add to the, it will sure add, raise the level of enjoyment to the audience and to myself as well. Now, I would like to say I really enjoyed it. It's very interesting. As for me, I have never been a fan of anybody, so it's good for me to know the first-hand experience. And I hope you find my suggestions useful. Contestant.
Newton, one of the greatest scientists who discovered the gravity, was inspired by a falling apple. I hope I could be the apple for you first. Fellow Toastmasters, distinguished and accomplished guests, good afternoon. May you allow me to divide your presentation into two parts, delivery and your structure. Each one was one credit for you. Personally, Merce, you have already hold one credit in your hand. I do appreciate your personal performance of your delivery, your vocal variety, and also your gestures, body languages. It's more than content to be a Toastmasters. So I would like to focus on your structure. Let's give a review for the whole presentation from the very beginning. She was abrupt to arouse the audience's attention, and obviously, I'm with you all the way. I was attracted by your props. And then you tell us how fans, they're enthusiastic for their idol. And you try hard to tell me that the value of reality, and also don't judge a person or a book by its cover, which is a very meaningful and educational speech you have done. But personally, I would like to give you some suggestions. The first one, your props is very useful, but it's hardly visible. Try to make it larger. Try to make it big, so that the whole audience could see what you want to show. And therefore, you can reinforce your speech, but not ruin it. For the second point, you tell us stories on your speeches. But Leslie was personally involved. If you can add up more personal things happened in yourself, then you can connect the audience. You can link the audience. You bring us closer and make us think deeper. And the third point is, you give us the whole situation. You give us the why fans, they are crazy for their idols. But I didn't see the conclusion. If you can add up some elements and reinforce was your conclusion, and all the amazing speech you did. All in all, let's go back to the very beginning. Critics, one for delivery and one for structure. 1 + 1 = 2. Sometimes it will be less than 2. But I could tell you, Merce, your potentially will be more than 2. Contest chair.